Big man. Righteous man.
Whoa, easy.
Blue lives matter.
You thought I forgot about you? We got unfinished business.
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Mark Dark, and I'm back with another video. If you're new, if you love For Life, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like the video, and leave your theories, comments, everything down below. Now, today, we're going to be talking about For Life, Season 2, Episode 10. This is my quick review of the season finale. Now, For Life Season 2, I'm not going to even lie to you guys. A lot of people haven't been supporting Season 2 like that, so, of course, I didn't really drop a recap for the last two episodes like that, but I will still always give you my thoughts of the episode with this review. Now, as far as this season finale, of course I wanted to drop my review for you guys earlier, but things came up. We had Snowfall returning. I also had to do other shows and get other content out that people supported more, so it made more sense for me to do those shows first. Now, as far as For Life Season 2, overall, we got 10 episodes. We know in Season 1, I believe in Season 1, we got about 13 episodes of For Life. And after watching, and when I compare both seasons, to be honest with you guys, and I've told you this in the past, For Life Season 1 to me was better. It was at a different level to me. The feel of the show was just better overall to me, and I really liked Season 1 more. Not to say that Season 2 is not good. I think it is. It's solid. It is good. They are using things that are happening in our world today, and they are incorporating that into the show, and they're showing us those different, you know, issues within the show, which is good. You know, they're putting the whole COVID thing in there, you know, Black Lives Matters, the things that we're seeing in today's world, and that's cool. But by doing all those things, to be 100% honest, I think it kind of lost a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people said, you know what? I don't know if I really want to watch For a Life like that. Like I told you guys, I was more intrigued, and you know, I really liked Season 1 way better than Season 2. But you know, it is what it is, man. Things change. Now I'm going to talk about what happened in Episode 10, the season finale, which I think was a solid episode, but it didn't really deliver what I wanted it to. And this is just my opinion. Of course, I really wanted to give you guys the final predictions for the season finale. But like I said, we didn't really get a whole lot of support when it came to For Life. But as far as this season finale, my overall review is this. We knew that, of course, those officers, you know, they weren't going to give them the full max, you know, sentences that they really needed. Of course, they were going to give this cop the lesser charge. You know what I'm saying? If you notice while watching the whole season, every time that your boy Aaron Wallace got closer to gathering information, from getting information with his team, every time they was about to present this or use it, they kept getting knocked right back down. We talking about from the video, I mean, from the store owner not really trying to, you know, help them out. I mean, the video getting stolen from him, from the cop. I mean, it was always these different reasons over and over on why they couldn't use this evidence. I mean, they didn't even put, I would have at least put the information out to the public of the killing. That didn't even get put out from my understanding, right? They had the opportunity to do it, but they said, you know what, we're not going to put that out. They didn't do it. Of course, I knew they was going to wait to the very end to finally bring the son to the stand, which is something that I think they should have done in the first place. You know what I'm saying? I thought they should have brought him up there in the first place and let him give his side of the story. The kid was there, and why not put him on the stand from the jump? But I understand they wanted to use all the different outlets. They did not want a kid going up there. But besides the fact, you can just see what was about to happen. To me, it was very predictable. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I really wish I would have did that final predictions, because I just knew they wouldn't go get this cop what he really deserved. They gave him, of course, the lighter charge. Did not get the manslaughter charge at all, which we already knew was not going to happen, right? So this whole time I'm watching the episode and I'm like, okay, let's just get to the end of this because it's getting stretched out. I just want to see the aftermath. What are they going to give him? And to be 100% honest, more importantly, I was just ready to see Cassius Dawkins. I was ready to see your boy 50 Cent on screen. That's what I was waiting for, to be 100% honest with you guys. I feel like this case has been stretched out. Now, that's just me. That's just my opinion. Now, they gave us the results And of course, Andy Josiah's wife came up there. She gave a good speech and everything like that. Now, the judge did give the cop the max sentence of the shorter charge, which was 4 years, which is cool. You know what I'm saying? At least he's getting something, but we knew they weren't going to hit him with the manslaughter charge. His whole team was just dirty. I mean, come on. I mean, at the end of the day, it is what it is. They played him at the end of the day. We got a family with no father. And once again, it's just pissing people off. At the same time, after this case, after everything happened, right, they give us 30 seconds. Not even 30. What was that? 15, 20 seconds of Cassius Dawkins. At the very end of the episode, we get a little bit of sense of how the show used to be. At least that old feeling of course, Aaron wanting to help out Jamal. If you guys notice, at the very beginning of the season, the storyline was, okay, Aaron gets out. He wants to help get some more prisoners out. He was trying to help Jamal out at the very beginning. But that storyline, if you notice, kind of got scrapped, right? It kind of got scrapped and threw under the bus. And then they're bringing it back out once again. Now, I can be completely wrong. And I could have sworn I read something, some article, and they said that they took the second half of the season to put a little bit more focus on COVID-19 and also the social injustices of this country. Now, this is what I read. They wanted to incorporate that into the storyline way more. So that's why I believe after like episode 5 or 6, I believe after the break that we got, you started to see almost like a shift within the show. The show kind of changed a little bit. They started to switch over a tad bit, in my opinion, at least. We got what we got, but at the end of the day, the storyline of Jamal, Cassius Dawkins, the storyline that we saw at the very end of episode 10, this is the storyline that I've been waiting for. You know what I'm saying? Because Cassius Dawkins is not just going to walk away, especially after getting that beat down, especially after Jamal messed up his game plan on taking out Aaron Wallace. I mean, that's not just going to go away. They brought it back at the very end, which I believe they're going to try to shoot a season 3. I believe your boy 50 Cent was upset. He put out like I believe on his Instagram, where he tweeted out a few weeks back, and he was talking about, okay, I see people are not supporting the show like that. But this is one of the best shows, but people are not so really supporting. I believe the numbers have not been as good. You know what I'm saying? You guys can go look that up, but I'm almost certain that the numbers wasn't as good compared to season 1. To me, overall, I think season 2 was solid, but coming from season 1, I don't think that season 2 was better. And not to say that season 2 was bad, I really like season 1 better. And you know, that's just me. I like the whole storyline of Aaron trying to get his fellow inmates out of jail, even though he got out, which was cool. He gets out, but the whole Cassius Dawkins storyline, and what he had going on with Maskins and stuff like that, that was a whole nother storyline and world that I was ready to watch and ready to see, which we really did not see at all in this season. So in season 3, if they decide to do that, hopefully it goes back to how I believe they originally wanted to do it. I know a lot of fans was upset with this season because they were saying, how did it switch from going from Aaron gets out all of a sudden to COVID-19? Because a lot of the people that's watching this show, they understood the show as being a story about Isaac Wright Jr. So when we watch it now, it's about different things that's going on in the world today. But they use different names and stuff like that. Some of the names are the same, but they wanted to see more of the story of Isaac Wright Jr. and what we saw in season 1, which we really didn't see in season 2. Regardless if he did get out, we still have more unanswered questions, more storylines that could have carried from season 1 that could have went into season 2 that we did not see. But you guys let me know, man. This is just my overall review of season 2 of the season finale. I thought it was okay, man, but I really did appreciate season 1 way more. You know what I'm saying? Just think about it. When your boy Cassius Dawkins walked on that bus, I believe it was season 1, episode 5, when it was playing that Pop Smoke, I swear to you, that was probably one of my favorite scenes of For Life. And that whole season just made a dramatic change. It just felt like a different show. The show went to a new level. So if I understand that, which I think is great and I think is good, the writers definitely understand that. And the reason why I say they understand that is because that's why they use Cassius Dawkins in the season finale, because they know the fans love 50 Cent and they love the character and what he brought to the show. This is why, in my opinion, why they used him in the preview trailers, because people wanted to see if something good was going to happen. By showing Cassius Dawkins in the preview trailer, everybody's going to probably start trying to tune in to see what's going to happen with 50 Cent's character. He is back. Okay, let's see what happens. But we didn't really see him like that, right? Didn't really see him at all, for real. But it is what it is. Hopefully, they change it up. But I want to thank you guys for supporting, at least. Keep supporting your boy. I will continue to give you guys more For Life content, especially if they do give us a season 3. I guess we got to wait and see based on the numbers on what they really want to do. But thank you for all the support and all the love. And I will catch y'all on the next one. But let me go out of here, man. It's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.